sale.
Let's see if this will work.
Bring that Spider-Man. Bring that Spider-Man.
Hurry up, man. He's singing. Get the fuck up there.
Get it on, man.
It only vamped for so long, Staggle.
My turn, man.
Yeah, how y'all doing?
We're doing good, baby.
Yeah, the little crowd just walked out. It's still good, though.
I'm about to get up right now.
Please, don't get
up.
They gone. They gone, but it's cool.
No, they're for real. They're right here.
They still there? Yeah, because this right here, this is what I'm used to. You know, the chairs is my biggest audience. You know? That for real, man. Every show I've been booked on, man. They booked me at a show one time at the J Spot. They said the show started at 8 o'clock. I got there at 7 o'clock. Hell, I didn't hit the stage at 12:30. And I said, shit, y'all should have told me I was going to get on stage on the 16th, not the 15th. Y'all got me fucked up. And I had more people in the crowd than anybody in that motherfucker.
That's why you went last.
Yeah,
man. You want to hold the crowd.
I had to learn the game the hard way, man.
The game.
This game right here is to be sold, not to be told, and I had to get in and learn it the hard way by getting in it.
Hell yeah,
and,
man.
You know, I just jumped on stage and started telling jokes one day, and motherfuckers, you know, some kind of way they started to embrace me, you know. It wasn't the comedians that kept me going, it was the crowd. When I got off the stage, they were like, oh man, you're good, man. You gotta keep going, man. We're gonna see you one day. I'm like, yeah. Tell people all the time, man, when I started doing comedy, man, I started doing comedy to be rich and famous. I didn't start doing comedy to be famous and broke. Y'all never see me looking like AJ Johnson. Easy. All Friday. Everybody in the world know your name. Everybody know you ain't got a goddamn thing. Broke ass motherfucker. Motherfucker got a 1989 Mercedes Benz with the fender knocked off in the front. And got nerve to park it in front of the goddamn club. You don't take that broke ass shit. You know, that's what I get to talking about, you know what I'm saying, ladies, man. Ladies, y'all need to, you know, step y'all game up and learn how to evaluate these niggas more better. You know what I'm saying? Because these niggas be fooling the shit out of y'all with three good outfits and a bullshit ass car. Y'all swear to God, y'all got y'all something, but y'all ain't got shit. I got this new motherfucking app that I'm designing, and it's called the KBBPV. That's the Kelly Blue Book Pussy Value. And it's got a DV in the inside of the app, and it's for the ladies. So when you wanted to check on a man, you go to the DV, and that's the Kelly Blue Book Dick Value. And it's pretty much based on the codes and the car that nigga driving. And it pretty much evaluates and tell you how much that nigga worth. Prime example, you can roll up on a man right now in a 2004 BMW 745. Yeah. It looked like the new model, but it really ain't shit. It's a rich man's trash and a poor man's treasure. But to a broke motherfucker that ain't never had shit, they swept it down, they got a good car. But that's a good expensive car that's gonna cost your ass the maintenance, that motherfucker that you can't afford. That's why the rich man traded that motherfucker in for the newer version, because he said it's time to kick this bitch back. But y'all don't know nothing about that. If you ain't never had no money, then you don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. And the average motherfucker that say that money ain't shit is a motherfucker that ain't never had none. That's real shit. Every motherfucker that I ever known that say, oh man, money ain't shit, you don't need money to live, you don't need money to do shit. Nigga, you ain't never had none. You was a broke motherfucker. Because it ain't been a day in my life, man. Not one day in my life have I ever woke up and I was with my freedom. Like, even in prison, though, I can speak even in prison. It hadn't been a day in my life that I had not had to spend some money to live. Like, for real. And that's some real shit. You gonna have to spend some money and take money to make money. And I tell motherfuckers all the time, if I was there to get some money, they done gave the wrong nigga money, wrong nigga money. I can show these niggas how to motherfucking do it. Yeah. You know, the first thing I'm gonna do when I get a bunch of money, if I was to become a billionaire overnight, well, not even a billionaire. I want to be a quadzillionaire. I try to tell people, I try to think big. You know, quadzillion is a lot of numbers. You know, the average person don't even know how many zeros is in a quadzillion. You know how many zeros in a quadzillion?
A bunch.
Yeah, 16 to be exact. I just like to tell that number because, you know, mathematics has always been my favorite subject. If I can't read, I can damn sure count some money. goddamn right. I've been to the pen 6 times, and every time I went, it was in the name of getting money. Real talk. I tell people that shit. When I came out of prison the last time, I made a vow to God that I was going to change my life, and he gave me a brilliant idea to become a comedian. Because that was the only thing I could do. I couldn't go get me a job. Y'all imagine, a person like me, I done been in jail for kidnapping, armed robbery, I don't even want to talk about other little things, aggravated assault. I'm just gonna talk about some of the things that I got away with, even though I got convicted for it, I got away with it because I'm out. But they was all violent, they fucked up. The last job I had, I slapped the shit out of my supervisor. Yeah, because he told me, man, that after I worked a double, that if I left, I was gonna be fired. And I told his ass, I wanna see your ass fire me because at 7 o'clock I gotta be right back at my shift. And I worked a double shit. I started this motherfucker 7 o'clock in the morning and it's 11 o'clock at night and the state don't pay overtime, motherfucker. By law, they ain't gonna pay me not a penny over 16 hours. So I'm gonna take my motherfucking ass home. You are not my supervisor. I helped y'all over. And that's y'all goddamn fault, y'all motherfucker running behind. I'm out of here. So at 11 o'clock, I showed him. I'm better than I can tell you. I walked out and I swiped that clock. I don't know what that motherfucker Pepperwood did. But when I came back at 7 o'clock that morning, security would not let me on the premises. They said that I was terminated. I said, how in the hell did I get terminated? He said, the motherfucker supervisor fired your ass. I was like, how in the fuck? That wasn't my supervisor. He said it wasn't, but he was a white one. That should have waked y'all up in the morning. I was in Mississippi, and that was the last time I got fired by a white man.